Hello everyone, this video is about a selection of locals. Stay with us. Never had a lot of shit come easy. Had
to work hard, struggle just to be me. Let's say this is the player and it's going to look at this target. Now what does this looking at mean? It means the Z argument of the rotation section changes. For example, if the target comes down, the player will change its angle again as if it is looking at the target. Open the script and up here define a game object named as target. Now in update void, write vector 3 any name you want, like look, equals to transform dot inverse transform point, then in parentheses write target's position. In next line, define a float like angle, which supposed to be z of rotation, equal that to mass f dot attend to. Then in parentheses write x and y of defined vector times to mass f dot rad to deck. The code is a bit ridiculous, you just copy it. The only thing we have to deal with is the angle. For example, the work of Atantu is that it takes the tangent between two objects, which we have nothing to do with this at all. We just need a copy of this. Now you just should equal player's z of rotation with angle. So write transform dot rotate 0 0 and the last one angle. You can do it by different ways. Give the code to player, then drag target towards it. After play, you can see the player looks at the target with a 90 degree difference. To fix this, open the code again and the end of rad to deck write minus 90. It's done. Now you can see the player looks at the target correctly. Anything can be placed in the target's place. The mouse, the user's finger, the enemy, or anything else. Locat is much easier in 3D structure than in 2D structure. Suppose this object is player and this object is the enemy. Open the script. Again, define a target game object, write in update transform.locat, then in parentheses write target's position. Give the script to player and drag enemy towards it. Do the same for enemy too, till these both look at each other. After playing, you will see that when we move the player, both the enemy and the player look at each other. If you go to the scene tab, cause the camera is player's child, you will see the camera rotates with the player and look at the enemy too. Another sample of look at the structure is when object or player moves in a special path, it looks at its path. For example, watch this arrow. When it shoots, it should look forward. This is a perfect shot example that looks forward, and we wanna achieve this. To produce and shoot the arrow, use this code. This part is for right click, this part is for producing, and this part is for shooting the arrow, which in later tutorials we will talk in details. Now let's get to our main work, locat. Open a new script. Up here define a 2D rigid body called, for example, RB, then change SR to update or create a new update void, cause this command must run constantly. This command is a little weird, it's just made for copy, I guess. Define a float for angle and equal it to mass f.attentu. In parentheses write x and y of RB's velocity, then times this with rad to deck. It's a bit strange, but that's what it is. To change the object's angle, you can use different ways again. I use transform.rotation. Write transform.rotation equals to quaternion.angle axis, then in parentheses write defined angle and vector3.forward. I know it's a little complicated, you just copy and paste it. Now give a rigid body 2D to the arrow and give the script to it, then drag the rigid body to defined RB. When you play, as you can see after shot, the arrow doesn't look forward exactly. Why? Because of the default state of array image. After opening the image, you see there is a difference of almost 45 degrees. To fix it, open the script and subtract 45 from rad to deck, which converts radians to degrees. Now press play for last time. You will see after shooting an arrow, the arrow looks to its path.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe us.